now from South Seminole Academy in Castleberry, Florida. Direct from the third floor of building number 3, this is South Seminole News.
Good morning, Hurricanes. Happy Thursday. I'm Juliana.
And I'm Preston. It's September 2nd, 2021. Welcome to South Seminole News. At this time, please stand for the pledge.
Let's check in with Hunter for the daily report. Good morning, Hunter.
Good morning, guys. Today's weather is cloudy with a chance of rain in the forecast. It's warm out with a high of 84 degrees. Keep the umbrella close by. A reminder, if you take any photos of yourself this school year, send them to us at southseminolenews@yahoo.com so that we can put them on the news. Now let's take you to the South Seminole Lounge for the lunch report. Good morning, guys.
Good morning, everyone. Today's lunch special is baked pasta with broccoli and a garlic stick breadstick. All meals include fruit, vegetables, and milk or juice.
If you or your class would like to record anything here in the South Seminole Lounge for the Friday afternoon show, please contact the newsroom.
You can find the Friday show every week on YouTube at South Seminole News. We'll see you next time. Now back to you at the studios.
Thanks. Once again, you will find more news from the South Seminole Lounge on the Friday afternoon show on our YouTube page.
Be on the lookout for a different segment every day of the week. The Dean's Den on the Friday afternoon show, Mr. Fernandez and Ms. Pearson, Mindset Monday with Dr. Coleman, a new segment called Deep Thoughts with Dr. McDonald on Tuesday,
Win-Win Wednesday with Ms. Reed, Mertz MVP on Thursday, and Fabulous Friday with Ms. Mahfouz.
A message from the SSA yearbook staff. If you take any good photos, send them to ssayearbook@yahoo.com. If the yearbook staff likes your photos, they may end up in the book.
Take photos all school year and send in your best ones. Good luck, school photographers.
We're going to take a commercial break. When we come back, we'll tell you about the Beta Club store and Mercer's MVP.
We'll be right back after this.
Attention all students, SSA's Cohesion Step Team is back. They will be hosting Step Team tryouts for the 2021-2022 school year on Tuesday, September 7th and Wednesday, September 8th.
On Tuesday, tryouts will be from 4:15 p.m. to 6 p.m. and Wednesday from 3:15 p.m. to 5:30 p.m. All attendees will meet in Ms. Barber's room after school.
Any student who is interested or would like to be on the team is encouraged to attend. No experience is necessary.
Please see Ms. Barber in room 308 for a permission slip. Thank you.
Welcome back. A message from Mr. Motley. Every Friday during 8th period, students will pick up your recycling.
Place your box outside your classroom after 3 p.m. on Fridays. If you need a recycling box, please contact Mr. Motley.
Attention all students. The Beta Club store is now open for business. Please remember there are a few rules.
You can visit in between classes. However, a pass will not be written if you're late for your next class. Please manage your time wisely.
Also, if you come during class, you must have a pass from your teacher. And as always, you must be in uniform to visit the store.
This year, the store will offer many items, including sodas, Gatorade, chips and candy, and so much more.
Please visit room 36 on the first floor or visit room 221 on the second floor. Thank you to the Beta Club for opening up your store again this year.
Attention students, South Seminole Academy will have a picture retake day on Monday, September 27th.
Please go to www.mylifetouch.com to sign up. Picture will be taken in Leadership Hall on that day.
Thank you to Mr. Heist's first period student government class for handing out the SCPS school year calendar.
Teachers, if you have any extra calendars, please return them to Mr. Heist in room 233 so that they may get to all the students that need one.
A reminder from Coach Payne that your next cross-country practice will be on today after school from 4:15 to 5:30.
If you have any questions about this season, make sure to see Coach Payne or Coach Jackson in the gym.
And now we take you to Mertz MVP.
All right, welcome Hurricanes. This is Mr. Mertz, and I'm back with another episode of Mertz's MVP. Today, I have a very special guest with me, Miss Jemiah Simpson. Hi. Welcome, Jemiah.
Hello.
This one is a special one for me because Jemiah has shown me she can overcome adversity, and those are my favorite type of students. My favorite MVPs in life are students that overcome adversity. Now, when I first met Jemiah, this is going to be, I believe, Jemiah's third year with us now. When I first met Jemiah, and I used to do this a lot. We used to butt heads a lot. Those of you who know me know I'm very strict. I'm very big on structure and discipline. I'm very big on following the rules. And when you're not following the rules, I kind of call you out on it to help you get to where you need to be and help you understand the importance of following rules and structures. Maya didn't used to react to that so well. So me and Jemiah did a lot of this. So this year, since we started a brand new school year, she's one of our leaders on campus in eighth grade. And she has been leading by example, showing terrific behavior, terrific manners, getting to class on time, doing all her schoolwork in class, excelling so far in her classes, and I've been getting good reports from her teachers and good reports from fellow administrators on campus, and I've seen it with my own two eyes. So that shows me that Jemiah's come a long ways, overcome some adversity and some conflict with me, and is getting to where she need to be. Now, I love students who can overcome conflict, because one thing I want you all to remember is there's a big difference between conflict and confrontation. And our goal is you're never going to be able to avoid conflict in your life. I promise you, no matter what age you are, you're always going to have conflict in your life. The important part is to not allow that conflict to turn into confrontation, because that's when you go down a bad road. What's so important is learning in life to deal with conflict, talk about conflict, communicate with the person you have a conflict with in a healthy manner, and not avoid. When we avoid at this age, then it's going to lead into bad things down the road as an adult, and that habit will continue. So I'm seeing that in my own two eyes. Jemiah's done awesome this year. She's learning to attack conflict head on by communicating, by talking, by using manners, and I'm just so proud of her. So I feel like very long-winded today. I said a lot, so I'll stop and get into our segment. Jemiah, what is your favorite thing about South Seminole and why?
My favorite thing about South Seminole, you know, is basketball and learning how to, like, get along with new people and, like, making a difference this year instead of, like, doing what I did last year, because I had to, like, look at, okay, this is me now. Instead of blaming anything on other people, I have to look at me and get myself in order first.
That is awesome. You've learned to take accountability, responsibility, and I think you've realized the power you have on our campus. Like, you're a leader, so whichever way you lead, good or bad, others follow you and look up to you. You're a leader, and we appreciate that. So who was your favorite teacher at South Seminole and why?
I'll have to say Chief Jackson, because I liked it going to his ROTC class, and I liked the discipline and the structure that he had, and how he was, like, powerful, and how he, like, everyone, he had the ROTC in order. Whatever he wanted, he got it done. That's what I like about
him. Amen to that. Structure and discipline is something Mr. Mertz is really big on, for any of you new at the school. And sometimes I hear, why are you so hard on us? Why are you so hard on us, Mr. Mertz? And I'm going to just say, structure and discipline sets the tone for the rest of your life. So if you learn at this age, as a teenager, a pre-teenager, how to live with structure and discipline, those habits will carry over into your adult life, no matter what you choose to do, where you go to college, what trade you do, what career, what job, and you're going to be very thankful that you learned structure and discipline at a young age. Awesome. All right, my final question, Jemiah, who is your role model and why?
I would say my role model is, I would say Miss Pearson.
Okay.
Because, like, over, like, the 3 years that I've been here, like, anything that has anything going on, she would, like, deal with it properly. But me, I never say anything because I'm keeping it myself. But, like, I like the way that she deals with things, like how she doesn't get things, like how she don't let it get to her. And me, I was like, okay, I want to be like that. And then I start, like, working on myself, and now that's how I like to be. Like, if someone says something, it's not going to get on me because I have my own peace. You know.
That's awesome. Living with peace and not reacting is so key in life. And shout out to Miss Pearson. We know her as a second mom here at the school, so that's a good thing. All right, well, that concludes our show today. Jemiah, do you have any message you want to give to the 6th, 7th, 8th graders, any students here on campus?
I would like to say, like, anything that you want to put your mind to, start now, because, like, you don't have to, like, let anyone get to you. If it's not true, then don't get worked up about it. I mean, because I used to do that, but it didn't get me nowhere but in trouble. So that's what I would say.
Whew, such a powerful message. I love it. Please stay on this track, Jemiah. We love it. I love seeing you as a leader. I love seeing you as a role model at the school. And I can't wait to see you go on to high school, college, and bigger and better things in life. All right, that's all. Hurricanes, don't forget to storm.
Thank you, Mr. Murph. Look for his segment every Thursday morning on South Seminole News.
That's all for today. Make sure you check us out on Instagram, YouTube, Twitter, and TikTok in South Seminole News. And don't forget to like and subscribe.
Also, please like the South Seminole County and PTSA Facebook pages for more info.
And students, every day here at South Seminole Academy, we strive for success, take responsibility, opt to lead, respect others, and make good choices.
Thanks for watching. I'm Preston.
And I'm Juliana. Have a great Thursday, and
don't forget to storm!